many times a year, you can imagine the step of faith that mum and the family would have to leave on the place which was home, and they would make their way up this pilgrim. As they literally went up to the 2,500 feet, the 800 metres up to Jerusalem, they began with the songs of ascent. And Dad would say to the family, as he would be the Rosh, the head, these words: I will lift up my eyes to the hills from whence comes my help. And the reply from the family: my help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. He will not allow your foot to be moved, and he who keeps you will not slumber. Behold, he who keeps Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is your keeper. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve you from all evil. He will preserve your nephesh, your soul. The Lord will preserve your going out and your coming in from this time forth and even forevermore. That beginning of the Song of Ascent from Psalm 121 is today still the encouragement, motivation, hymn, we would say, that the IDF forces sing to themselves: he who keeps Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. And verse 8 says, he will bless the going out and the coming in. How do we know? Because all the backpackers who come to our home tell us that this psalm, is what they sing as encouragement and motivation. Psalm 121. I finish with a third brief reading from the book of the prophet Nabi Isaiah. You'll know that Isaiah has 66 chapters, just as this book has 66 books. Humanly speaking, written by 440 men over 1500 years, yet with one central message, the message of the Lamb. You'll find the Lamb on the altar in the Tanakh. We read of him as the Lamb on the cross in the Gospel. And in the last book, the unveiling of that which was previously hidden, he's the Lamb on the throne. He's a lamb for an individual in Genesis 4. He's the lamb for a family, Pesach, Passover, Exodus 12. He becomes the lamb for the nation, Isaiah 53. And it was John the Baptizer who identified him, who lived his life at Nazareth, was baptized in the Jordan. Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world, an individual, a family, a nation, the world. And in Isaiah 40, it begins the second section. The first 39 chapters of Isaiah, judgment, just as the books beginning in the book of beginnings, in the beginning God. In our Bible, in the book of Malachi, the last word is the word of the sleep. Curse. How does it begin with God and end with a curse? When that's read publicly, it is repeated. The verse prior is repeated because they don't want to end. God, because of his covenant love, turns the curse into blessing. Because of the new covenant that's come in the Lamb of God. The presentation of Matthew begins with the presentation of the King. What's the last word? Amen, of course. In Revelation 22. It's the word of his covenant grace for all. I think we should do two things, is we glorify him. As Isaiah 40 and verse 8 and 9 says, say to the cities of Judah,